What do you do if you're bit by a snake? Stay tuned to find out. Hey there, Venomous viewers. Jules here for D News. Being bitten by a snake is no laughing matter. Neither is being stung by a swarm of bees, attacked by black widows and scorpions, stabbed by a stingray, or envenomated by a blue-ringed octopus. All these animals are considered venomous, which means that they carry a toxin that can be injected to produce a harmful response in another animal. Now, it's important to note that although some venomous animals can be deadly, like the box jellyfish, a huge number of venomous animals pose little to no risk to humans. For example, although all 2,000-ish species of scorpion carry venom, only about 30 or 40 of them have venom strong enough to kill a person. And your risk goes down even further if you have access to the right antivenom, which is sometimes known by its original terminology of antivenin. Thanks to the prevalence of antivenom, you're 9 times more likely to die from being struck by lightning than to die from a snake bite in the United States. But that's not true everywhere in the world, and that's a big problem. In Africa, one popular antivenom, which was used to treat 10 types of snake bites in the sub-Saharan region, ran out in June 2016 because the existing stock expired and the company making it couldn't continue producing it. That's largely because making antivenom is an expensive and complicated process. So, how is it done? Venoms come in different forms and functions, with different types of toxins, which is why there's not yet a universal antivenom. So let's take a look at the Deathstalker scorpion as an example of how venoms work. One of the toxins in this venom is a protein called chlorotoxin. This acts on cells in your body by blocking the molecular channels on the surface of the cell. In muscle cells, this forces them to tense up, leading to paralysis and a whole host of other negative effects that can lead to death. But antivenom is full of antibodies, which bind to these toxins and change their shape, preventing them from blocking those channels. The problem is, for many venoms, humans don't produce the right antibodies on our own. Instead, we have to rely on horses, goats, sheep, donkeys, rabbits, cats, chickens, camels, and even sharks to produce them for us. We pick these animals because they have immune systems that create the right antibodies for the right toxins. So to make antivenom, we inject these animals with a diluted form of the venom and an adjuvant, which is something that helps create a stronger immune system response. And just like with a vaccine, their immune system responds, producing antibodies. The animal's blood is then extracted, and the antibodies are separated out and used to treat humans. It sounds simple, but it requires a lot of complicated steps. Getting snake venom requires you to actually milk the snakes, and it takes many, many milkings, in some cases tens of thousands, to produce even 1 pint of venom. And after all this work, taking the antivenom doesn't give you lifelong immunity. Instead, it's a form of passive immunity, which means the antibodies aren't coming from your own immune system, and you'll need more antivenom if you get another bite or sting. The good news is that researchers are developing antivenoms that work on multiple types of species. In a 2016 study published in PLOS Neglected Tropical Diseases, researchers created a new antivenom by taking 12 venom samples, 9 of which were filtered to contain only the most toxic proteins, and then combining them together in a solution. This was injected into a horse, and the resulting antibodies ended up neutralizing the bites of 18 Asian and African snakes. Venom is nasty business, but luckily, if you've got antivenom handy, in particular the right kind of antivenom, then chances are you'll probably survive. That is, unless you're attacked by a blue ring octopus, because there's no antivenom for those. So be especially careful when swimming in Australia and the eastern Indo-Pacific. Good luck out there. And if you want to know more about venom, specifically snake venom, you can check out this video right here. So, what are you most afraid of being bitten by? Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more episodes of D News every day.